Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, a warm welcome to each one of you to our special concert, Requiem. Let us begin this music concert. In the name of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us invoke God's blessings. Gracious God, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for this pleasant evening. We are grateful to you for gathering us in this manner to praise and adore you along with the Bangalore men and a cappella Bangalore, members of this choir who have come here to present Requiem, a special music concert. We invoke your blessings upon this concert organized by St. Mark's Cathedral Information Technology Committee as well as Mission and Evangelism Committee. Bestow your rich blessings on every member of Bangalore Men and a cappella Bangalore choirs, and very especially on their choir conductor, Mr. Jonas Oslon. We are grateful to you for these choirs, for this evening's musical concert, in order to raise funds for the construction of church cum tailoring center at St. Andrew's Church in KGF. Bless their music that it might glorify your holy name. May the talent that you have bestowed on them be used only to serve you. Let the music of each choir be a witness to your majesty and love, joy and peace, reminding us that you always are watching, listening, intervening and helping and bestowing your rich blessings on us. May your presence and beauty be found in every note, and may the words that are sung by each choir reach the hearts of your people so that they will draw closer to you. May your spirit guide us through every measure so that we might be instruments of your peace and proclaim your glory with glad voices. Bestow your grace upon IT committee convener, Mr. Santosh Baines, and Mission and Evangelism Committee convener, Mrs. Christy Joseph, and every member of these committees. Bless their arrangements in a very special way. Bestow your rich blessings on all those who are gathered this evening. Bless us, be with us, and glorify yourself through us. We commit ourselves in this concert. Glorify and magnify your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I invite the secretary of our cathedral, Mrs. Christy Joseph, to kindly come forward and extend a welcome.
On behalf of the presbyter in charge and the pastorate committee and the mission and evangelism committee, I would like to welcome each and everyone here present for this concert. Before I would like to thank God for all the help what he's doing to us. The Mission and Evangelism Committee, we are helping all the poor and needy in all the mission fields. We have 7 mission fields, which is in Chitradurga, Tumkur, Chikbalapur, Sulagunte, Kolar Goldfield, Hosur Berigai, and Bangalore Urban. We have all the mission, some mission fields, we have the tailoring centers. One of the tailoring centers is in Kolar Goldfield, that is KGF, in St. Andrew's Church. We are running this for nearly 2 decades. And there are many poor and needy people. They take the training of tailoring, And after the training, they go and get benefited and work in some of the garment industries in and around Kola gold field. We are doing this for many years, but 2-3 months back, our Reverend and patron, Reverend Clement Rajkumar, he was telling me we will go he wants to replace the roof of the church. And when we went for inspection, we saw the roof is in a very bad shape, including the walls. There were a lot of holes, and the wall is divided actually. There are many children and adults, they are coming for this training. And immediately my mission and evangelism committee members, they said, we have to bring down the building and build a new church come tailoring center. Otherwise, it is a risk for the children who are undergoing this tailoring training. So we decided in the mission and evangelism committee to demolish the building and construct a new church. And I am very happy the pastorate committee of St. Mark's Cathedral, they have given the consent to go ahead with that. And also, I am really thankful to the presbyter, and he got all the permission from the executive committee, and Bishop was so kind enough to give the consent to go ahead with the construction. And I am really thankful to my committees, especially Beyond and Wellington, who did all the drawings and planning of the church, and everything is approved. And also I am thankful to the missionary who is working there, Mrs. Selva Kumari and her husband, and the Reverend of St. Andrew's Church, Reverend Robinson, who got the permission from BGML. Because since it is in the mines, so we have to get the permission to build from BGML Association. So they have got the permission. So every permission is ready with God's help to do the construction. And the project is going to be 16 lakhs. So we have got initial some amount. Anyway, another 10 days, we are going to start the church constructions. And I'm sure with God's help, with God in front, we are going ahead with the construction. I'm sure our congregation members and elect members, please, you will help us to construct the church in Kolar Goldfield. And I'm really thankful to Santosh Baines, who is the IT committee convener, who gave the idea, Auntie, we will have a concert to raise the funds for Kolar Goldfield Church. Thank you so much, Santosh, and thank you so much all the choir members and the conductor for bringing this members and making this concert so memorable one. And we are also going to be benefited at large. Kolar Goldfield people, the poor and needy, going to have a church on their own and also a tailoring center. Thank you so much. God bless you all.
Let us enter into time of praise and adoration. Shall we all rise to our feet and sing to the glory of God, hymn number 36 in the red hymn book that is in your pews. Kindly use the red hymn book. Let us sing the hymn, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Over to a cappella Bangalore and the Bangalore men choirs, and I request the conductor Jonas to take over.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to St. Mark's. It's fantastic that we can be here yet again in this wonderful cathedral on MG Road in the heart of Bangalore. We are very grateful to the pastorate committee for allowing us to come and perform here in this fantastic acoustics and with this wonderful organ, which isn't a common instrument in India, as some of you perhaps know. Our repertoire today is from the French choral repertoire, and specifically by a composer called Gabriel Faure. And he was born in 1845. I have to cheat a bit, but he was born in 1845 in France, and he died in 1924. And that makes him a bit interesting, because when he started composing, Frédéric Chopin, the Polish composer, was still alive and writing his waltzes and nocturnes, etc. And when Faure died, then we were listening to jazz music and atonal music. So he is really one of those composers that is creating a bridge from the Romantic period to the new era with the atonal music and with the dissolution of harmony as we knew it. We are performing three pieces this evening. The first piece that we will sing is called Cantique de Jean Racine, chant by Jean Racine. And it's a short piece composed by Faure when he was only 19 years old. And he composed it for a composition competition in France, which he won. And we will be performing it in an arrangement for all male voices, which will be done then by the Bangalore men, together with Rebecca Thomas Colasso on the grand piano. And it's written very much in the romantic style of Faure, of his composition style, which I think you will hear. A lot of sweeping lines and legato and very romantic and dripping of toffee, you can say. The next piece, which you will sing after Cantique, is with the ladies, with Cappella Bangalore, with Rebecca on the organ. And it is called Messe Basse. And it's a short form of the Mass, the Kyrie, the Gloria, the Credo, etc., where certain movements are omitted. So in this version, we will hear the Kyrie, we will hear the Sanctus, the Benedictus, and the Agnus Dei, written quite late in Faure's composition career. It was actually written originally in 1881, but then it was recomposed and performed first time in 1906, which is after the Requiem. So it's the latest of his pieces. And I think that if you will listen, you will hear that Faure is actually starting to change the way he composes and moves on to a more daring and perhaps a little atonal way of approaching his music. But first, Cantique de Jean Racine.
Thank you.
as we continue our ceaseless praise and adoration, remembering the goodness of God and the manifold blessings that we have been receiving, shall we offer our thank offering as we sing hymn number 39 in the red hymn book. Hymn number 39, The Lord's My Shepherd.
Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for sending your Son into this world, that even in the midst of death we can praise you and we can experience the power of resurrection even in this world as we anticipate life hereafter. For the life you've given us, ever grateful. May the joy you give us keep us mindful. and for the peace you give us, may we share it with one another. Bless this offering in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
So, maybe I should, I stand here? Okay. The final piece of the evening is the Requiem, written by Faure between 1887 and 1890. And the Requiem is a mass for the ones that have left us. And this Requiem, the Faure Requiem, is really a mass for hope, peace and solace, not a bombastic depiction of a brutal death. Faure didn't write the Requiem with any for any specific reason, even though some time before he started off the composition, his mother has passed away. But when asked about it, he wrote it to basically showcase his view of death as not something to fear or be afraid of, but something peaceful and bright. And I think you will hear that in the music of the Requiem. There are some parts of it which are a little more frightening, if I should say like that, but most of the piece is really filled with anticipation and peace. It consists of different movements. It starts off with an introitus, antrit, and a kyrie, and the final piece is In Paradisum. And I would request that we, if you want to give us a hand, in the sense applause, not to sing with us, but if you would like to clap, please do so after the In Paradisum, the last movement, so that we keep the flow of the music intact. We will have two soloists joining us. We will have Anisha Chandy, soprano, which also sang the soprano solo in the Mespas. And we'll have Saul Mendegar singing the baritone solo. And we will all be guided from the grand piano by Ms. Rebecca Thomas Colasso. The piano, which is gracefully lended to us by the International Society for Music and Arts, and we thank Ms. Urmila Devi for graciously allowing us to use this magnificent instrument this evening. So, Requiem, Gabriel Faure.
Thank you.
My beloveds in Christ, I deem it a great privilege to thank all whose contribution and efforts has made today's concert, Requiem, a great success. I sincerely thank our dear Jonas, the conductor of A Cappella Bangalore, and the Bangalore men for accepting to organize this concert this evening in aid of our cathedral project in KGF. Words fail to express our gratitude to each member of the choir, A Cappella Bangalore, as well as the Bangalore men for their prayerful rendition with great devotion. We are thankful for their time, talents, and for their wonderful presentations. We are grateful to Rebecca T. Colacco for playing piano and organ. We sincerely thank Anisha Chandy and Som Mendiga for their presentations. I place on record our gratitude to the International Music and Art Society for giving us permission to use their grand piano. I express my deep sense of gratitude to our Cathedral IT and Communications Committee convener, Mr. Santosh Bains, for taking responsibility to organize this concert. Heartfelt thanks to our Cathedral Secretary, Mrs. Christy Joseph, and the convener of the Mission and Evangelism Committee, and the members of the Pastorate Committee for helping us to organize this concert. We are grateful to God for each one of you, for your gracious presence, and for your support to extend our love, love of Christ, to the people in Kolar Goldfields. May God reward your faith and faith actions. May God continue to glorify Himself in all that we do, think, and say for His glory. At this time, on behalf of the Cathedral, I request our Cathedral Secretary to present our token of gratitude to the choir conductor, our dear Jonas. I request him to kindly come forward and receive our token of love. We're also grateful to Rebecca T. Colacco for playing piano and organ. We want to recognize the contribution of our dear Santosh Bains. He's the convener of Cathedral IT and Communication Committee, who took responsibility to organize this concert.
I think it is appropriate time to dedicate this concert to the memory of the most honorable, the Queen Elizabeth II and the Supreme Governor of Church of England. So this concert goes to the memory of Queen Elizabeth II. We dedicate this on behalf of St. Mark's Cathedral Presbyter, the Pastorate Committee, and the Mission and Evangelism Committee. We dedicate this concert to the late Queen Elizabeth II, the Supreme Governor of Church of England. Thank you.
For the information of all those who are present here, this is the Anglican Church, and the Queen is the head of the Anglican Church. Next Sunday, 18th of September, during our 9 a.m. service, we're going to organize a special Thanksgiving service, thanking God for the leadership and initiatives and contributions of this great personality who has made an impact on everyone all over the world. We request you to kindly remember this Thanksgiving prayer in your prayers, and you are also welcome to participate. This would be an online prayer meeting, and this would be part of our service. So online link will be created and shared. We request you to kindly log in and express your gratitude to God for the blessings that we have received through this great person who is a great defender of the Protestant faith. We have come to the end of this concert. Now, with gratitude for all the blessings that we have received, let us commit ourselves into God's almighty hands and ask Him to abide with us as we sing our closing hymn, "Abide with Me, First Falls the Eventide," hymn number 357. 357.
Let us bow our heads in prayer. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, this provision in our lives to come like this as your family, to enjoy and cherish the gifts that you have given to us. We thank you, we praise you for all that you have done in our lives, O Lord. We thank you for your creation, preservation, above all the salvation that you have promised through your dear Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. The many gifts that we have received, the singing is one among the precious gifts indeed. As we use it to glorify your name, Lord, you bless us. Every beat, Lord, may enhance the joy of knowing you and coming closer to you. Help us, O Lord, even as we disperse from this place. We want you to go before us, to lead us and guide us, and be around us to fortify us and protect us from all evil and danger. Beneath us to uphold us, so that we may stand for which is good and beautiful in thy sight. Lord, behind us to recall when we go astray. Especially we pray at this moment, the conductor, the singers, the musicians, all those who have contributed to this concert. Bless them, O Master, immensely and generously, so that in the future to come, they may continue to glorify your name with the gifts that they have received from thee. We once again commit ourselves unto thy care. We ask this in the most precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us receive God's blessings in faith. Unto God's almighty hands, for his care, love, and protection, and all blessings, let us commit ourselves, very especially the choirs, a cappella Bangalore, and the Bangalore men, and the choir conductor, Jonas, and all that they plan to glorify God. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with each one of us, very especially with these choirs, the choir conductor, and all that we do, think, and say for God's glory, now and forever. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us depart in peace.
In the name of Christ.